As a Bloody Mayhem with LeVar Big Johnson, aka Black Superman. LeVar, getting ready for your fight here at Strikeforce, and about actually a week from today, man. Go ahead and talk about your training and your opponent.
Well, I've been training here at Pueblo Hawley off of Blackstone in San Jose. Got a really good team. Been working with Billy Evangelista, working with Cash, Brandon Cash, Ralph Alvarado, Gangster, Jasper Tayaba, you know, Freddie Page, and Rudy Cruz. So I got a gang of guys in here helping me out, getting me ready, prepared.
You've had a long layoff since your last fight. Probably around this time last year, you had your last fight over Strikeforce. Was that 11 second, 17 second knockout? What was that?
18 seconds.
18 second knockout.
Yes, sir.
Showtime knockout of the year.
I don't know about that, but it was good for me.
Definitely quick payday. You know, let's fast forward a little bit for a few months after that. I think it seems like everyone already knows by now. Accident. You know, issues happened during 4th of July. Just go ahead to talk a little bit about it, man.
4th of July, I went up to Bakersfield for a family reunion and ended up getting shot. About five of my family members got hit. One of my family members, Anthony Johnson, passed away. And I got hit three times myself. And, you know, just recovered, you know. It's been like 8 months now and I'm ready to get back in the cage and get paid, pay these bills.
I definitely saw you a couple weeks after your accident when you made it back home to Madera. What were you weighing then? 215 pounds?
probably. I lost a lot of muscle mass. Wasn't able to eat for a month or drink water or nothing. Everything was through a tube in my chest. So an IV. So yeah, definitely. I lost damn near everything. Started from scratch.
Seems like you're back up to your walk around weight, 245 pounds.
Yes, sir.
But from what I hear from your coaches is you're faster now.
I don't know about that. I was pretty fast before. If you've seen the last fight.
But everyone's saying you're faster, so that means there's going to be a more dangerous LeVar out there.
Yeah, I hope so.
Let's just hope your opponent doesn't have kryptonite in his gloves, because so far that seems the only thing that's going to be able to take you out these days.
Yeah, I hope not either, you know. Nobody wants to get beat up in their hometown on the main event. Anything like that, but you know, this is MMA. You never know what happens. If it does happen, then you know, that's part of the sport. You know, that's what we take. Every time we step in the cage, either you're gonna win or you're gonna lose. So second place ain't too bad.
Well, your opponent's from Hawaii, just as your last one. He's 4-0. Do you know anything about him?
He's a big guy. He's about 6'5", 260, stand up banger. And you know, he's a tough dude. I mean, all of his wins are, I think, by knockout or TKO. So, you know, that's the same thing as me. So, I mean, hopefully we put on a good show.
Well, it's definitely what you favor the most, right? It's a stand-up game. Yeah. Someone's gonna stand and bang with you.
Yeah, this, you know, that's what the crowd likes, especially with the heavyweights. Nobody wants to see two big heavyweights rolling around on the ground, you know, gasping for air. They want to see somebody get knocked out. So that's what I try to do. You know, I try to give the crowd what they want.
Well, let's favor it in your direction, and let's say next Friday you win at Strikeforce. What do you think should be your next step? There's a lot. I mean, this is a Strikeforce show. There's a lot of heavyweights at Strikeforce that are getting a lot of recognition right now. Mm-hmm. Any of those guys you'd like to fight?
I mean, Bob Cook is my manager. He's a manager for. We have managers for a reason. They pick who, you know, who they think is a good step for me and good pace. So, you know, I'll let Bob Cook handle all that. And, you know, whoever he brings, if it's Fedor, it's Fedor. If it's Brett Rogers, or even if it's another guy from Hawaii that nobody's heard about, bring him. That's what I do. I just show up to work.
You know, they just actually signed up Alistair Overeem versus Brett Rogers. I think that's going to be a pretty damn good fight.
I think so, too. Yeah, Overeem beefed up a little bit too. So, I mean, he got a great ground game, great, you know, striking. So, and he got a ton of experience. So, I mean, that could go either way.
Seems every time he's gonna fight in the U.S., he gets hurt, ends up fighting in Japan. But before your accident, it seems like they were actually gonna try to sign you up to face Brett Rogers, man.
Yeah. That's what right after the fight, that's what Bob had told me, that we might have seen Brett Rogers, but Arlovski took that fight, and thank goodness that wasn't me. So Yeah, but I mean, I don't think the fight would go the same way as Arlovski, but I'd put up at least a little bit more of a fight than 20 seconds.
Well, definitely, LeVar, you're a fan favorite here in the Central Valley, and you're starting to get well-known through the Strikeforce arena. Hopefully, if you know you win this fight and we do see you on one of Strikeforce's bigger cards, you know, maybe co-maining event or headlining one of those events. You know, definitely appreciate your time. Look forward to your fight. Any guys you want to thank right now?
Yeah, I want to thank especially my girl. She's been there for me, helped me out a lot through everything. Just want to tell her I appreciate it and I love her a lot. My team, Pro Bowl Hallways, been great with me. All my teammates, all the trainers that I mentioned before. The whole MMA community of Fresno, it's been really great. Red Wave Tattoo, Stealth Armor, and you know, just everybody in general. So all the people that you know, chipped in and donated some money to BloodyMayhem.com, I thank you for that. It's helped me out a lot, and you know, just everybody who's came along and helped me get to back on my feet and get back in the cage. There's just been a ton of people. I can tell you how much, but I am thankful for everything. So, of course, BloodyMayhem.com.
And well, since you said BloodyMayhem.com, also on the website there is a link to help out LeVar, take care of some of those medical payments because they were definitely super expensive.
Yeah, and I thank everybody for who's you know, donated something or not. I appreciate it. It's helped me out. You know, I struggled for the last 8 months of since I got paid. So definitely want to thank everybody who's pitched in.
And that link's on the main page on the right-hand side. So click on it. It goes to the PayPal account. You know, donate whatever you can. So appreciate the help, and thanks a lot.
Yeah. And now, most important of all, I got to thank Madtown. So come out here and watch your boy on Friday the 26th, and put it down for us one more time.